D, wait for it, Michael.
You got the name tag. You're in my world now, Grandma.
What's up, nerds? So for this episode, in case you didn't see the title, is I'm going to talk about action figures that were never made, but I wish they had been. I used to be a huge action figure collector, and I used to collect a whole bunch of them, but then I started running out of shelf space, and plus it was really expensive, you know, when you're shelling out at least $20 an action figure. It got to be too much and everything. Plus, you know, you can't collect everything, and so it just got to be too much. So I made a list of action figures that I wanted before I officially quit, which I didn't even get all of them, and that's fine because I'm pretty much done. If I ever did run into them, I probably would get them. So these action figures weren't made, but that doesn't mean like for instance, some of them are just in concept. Some of them are actually got to the prototype stage, and then some of them, they just, you know, were just, yeah, that's pretty much it. They just got to prototype stage, and then they just went away. So, let's go ahead and just jump right in. Now, the first one is not really an action figure. It's, King's Landing from Game of Thrones, and it was going to be done by McFarlane Toys. They were doing all these miniature, Game of Thrones, kind of like a build-your-army kind of thing. I'm not 100% sure how it went down. I didn't collect any of them. It's kind of like what they did with Lord of the Rings way back in the day. They made all these miniature, figures. They were about 2 inches tall. And then they had fortresses and stuff, but they never made this, and I thought it was really cool. I wish they had. It was a miniature of it, and it was really sweet, and I wish they had made it, and I probably would have picked it up. Now, the next one I want to mention is, it's Oren from Kill Bill. Now, this was done by NECA, and it was going to be released in their first series of the action figures. And it came with the Crazy 88, the three different members of the Crazy 88. It came with the little henchman girl, I can't remember her name. And then it came with the bride, one in the yellow jumpsuit. But one thing that was going to be was an Oren, and I liked this action figure. I thought she looked awesome. I was trying to collect all of the Viper Squad or whatever, and I thought they were really cool, but unfortunately this one only made it to the prototype stage, and I believe the reason that it didn't get made was because Lucy Liu, the actress, wouldn't give the rights to her image for the action figure, so it never got made, but it did make it to the concept process, and I was thankful that we got to at least see what it would have looked like, but unfortunately we didn't get it. The next one I'll talk about is the Mystique action figure from Days of Future Past, and that was going to be put out by Marvel Select. Now, this was, of course, the Jennifer Lawrence Mystique, and it also only made it to the prototype stage. It was put out at one of the toy fairs or something like that, and the reason that one didn't get made is because of Jennifer Lawrence wouldn't give her rights to her image. Now, that kind of seems like wishy-washy, because even though it is Mystique, it's like, she's blue, and I guess that's, you know, a legal issue or whatnot. So, that one did not get made, which is a super huge bummer. So, the next one I want to talk about is not just a single one. It's actually not a series, but, okay, so Tailspin came out in the 90s, and I was a huge fan of Tailspin and that whole Disney Afternoon collection of shows. They were all cartoons. They were all these anamorphic animals that could talk or whatever. So anyway, so Tailspin, they had some figures that they didn't make. The ones that made it to the prototype stage, and you can see it on the back card of the figurines, was Wildcat, Gibber, and Mad Dog. Now, I wish they would have made these. I have all of those action figures. They are, Funko is doing what they're calling the Disney Afternoon Collection, and they're making some of those. They did make a Baloo and a Louie. But I really hope that they maybe get to some of these figures that never got made. So ones from the Tailspin that didn't make it to the prototype stage, but it did make it to the concept, and I'll put some pictures up here of the ones were Shere Khan, Dunder, and Hacksaw. Now, Hacksaw and Dunder are part of the Don Carnage's pirates and everything. And it would have been nice to get these figures just because it would have added some more bad guys to your collection and you would have been able to play with them or whatnot. And I would have liked to have set them up and everything and just, you know, kind of show them off a little bit because I do like those figures. My kids like to play with them all the time and everything. And so, yeah. So then the next one I want to talk about is also a collection from, and that is from Darkwing Duck. Now, Darkwing Duck, they had a Series 1 come out of action figures, and I have all of them except for Darkwing Duck and the Duckwing, the plane that he flew in. But this one, this was Series 2. Now, in Series 2, we were going to get a load of new figures, and I'm going to tell you right now, I wish they would have made that. Some of the lesser ones that were kind of like cool but not really were members of Shush, and that was the they fought Foul, and that was Agent Grizz Likovov. I don't know what that is. Anyways, but he was like a bear and everything. He was one of the agents of Shush. And then we got J. Gander Hooter, and he was like the leader of one of the branches of Shush. And that would have been cool to have them because you could kind of play that whole. That whole 007 kind of thing, but in the duck world. So for the good guys, we were going to get Morgana, and she would have been another female one, because the only one we got from Series 1 was Gosling. So we got another female, and a love interest for Darkwing Duck. And then we also would have got for our very first Gizmo Duck, which is kind of like a bridge between DuckTales and Darkwing Duck. Now, with Gizmo Duck, we do get one with the new Funko Disney Afternoon Collection. We also get a Scrooge McDuck and a Darkwing Duck. We also get a Darkwing Duck, which is awesome. So I hope that they maybe take some of those and put them into, make some villains or whatever. Because the next ones that we're going to talk about are villains. And that is, we got a Liquidator, and he was, and then we got a Mega Duck and a Quacker Jack. So they made in the first series, they made a Bushroot and a Megavolt. So then you would have had all five, and that would have been nice to have to play with as a kid. And, you know, I mean, not as adults. I don't play with them. I just like to set them up. So one thing that was super fun, we also got a vehicle. It was a Darkwing Duck's helicopter. That would have been fun because you would have got another vehicle. But then what was super fun is what they did was they had these wind up henchmen, and they were kind of like a build an army kind of thing, like you see with some action figures. And with that one, for Bushroot's sidekick, we got a pizza mushroom in a Venus flytrap, and that would have been fun. I wouldn't have gotten a whole bunch of those, maybe like one of each, maybe two of each at the most, but that would have been fun. We also would have got the alien hats that when they jumped on top of you in the show, that they took over your body kind of thing. And then Tuscarini's penguins, that would have been fun because you could have collected those and had like his little henchmen and everything. And then something fun was you got a Foul foot soldier, and that would have been super fun because they put out those Shush action figures, plus you have Darkwing Duck. And then in the Series 1, they put out Steelbeak, and it would have been cool because he was a member of Foul, and he would have had some henchmen on top of that. So that would have been cool if they had made that, but they didn't and everything. So the last one I want to talk about is the one that I miss, I really wish they would have made the most, and that is the Weasley twins from Harry Potter. Now this was going to be a two-pack set, it was going to be put out by NECA, they had put out a whole bunch of action figures, I have all of them, and I really would have liked these two. I think that NECA did a good job with their Harry Potter action figures. Unfortunately, they didn't put out as many as I would have liked. But they didn't put these ones out. They only made it to the prototype stage. I think they look great. It just, again, would have been really great to have these two in my collection before they stopped. But McFarlane Toys is starting up their own Harry Potter action figures, and I'm pretty sure that they'll be on scale with the ones for NECA. So hopefully we'll get some. Maybe we'll get the Weasley twins with that. So tell me, what did you guys think about these action figures that I never got, that never made, but I wish they had been? Is there any of them that you wish had been made? Is there any that I didn't mention on this list and you want to put those in that section down below? Go ahead. I would love to see them and maybe research them and then add them to my list now. Go ahead and leave all your comments in that section down below. If you like this video, go ahead and hit that like button. I won't mind. If you're new to my channel, please hit that subscription button, and I would greatly appreciate it. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.
Hey nerds, if you like this video, go ahead and click that Geek What icon and subscribe. And if you like this video, join me every Thursday where you can check out ranks and reviews, videos just like this.